Finally, it's here. True Tesla lovers can sigh relief now that the Tesla semi-truck has made its first delivery. As usual, the truck packs lots of tech, but excels most theoretically in the range it could cover. But is this physically possible? Stay tuned as we get up close and candid with the newest truck on the road, the Tesla semi-truck. Let's see what the truck design looks like. The Tesla Semi has a unique cab architecture and possibly the cleanest design you've ever seen on a truck. It looks like it's from the future. A huge wraparound glass section front and center descends towards the frunk. The glass space is so big that the panels stretch to the doors. Tesla removed the door mirrors from the Semi to improve aerodynamics. Instead, cameras at the far back convey data to the inside displays. However, as shown in the updated official images published in this report, it is not bringing that feature into production. As an EV, the Tesla Semi features a blanked-off nose, while its chin has a relatively tiny air inlet to cool the battery, which lies between the front and rear axles. It features a 64 tractor arrangement with one axle in front and two axles in the back. The trailer bed and tow hitch are located at the back. Now let's hop to the interior and see what it offers. The interior is one of a kind. The driver's seat is centrally located, which Tesla claims to improve total view out the windshield. It has a crimson seatbelt. There are two more folding seats behind the driver's seat. On the extreme ends of the dashboard, there are two huge touchscreens. The interior is simple and tech-packed to ensure the driver gets the best experience. Another key area where the Tesla Semi treads new ground is safety. The Tesla Semi was supposed to come standard with the brand's enhanced autopilot suite of technologies, but that's yet to be confirmed. Automated emergency braking, front collision warning, and automatic lane keeping assist are among the safety features available. If the truck detects no driver input, it will remain in the lane, come to a slow and gradual stop, and phone an emergency number. The Semi has an improved traction control system to the peculiar folding of highly articulated vehicles, such as trailers, due to uncontrolled inertia. Tesla engineers have included an enhanced traction control technology that completely eliminates this. The Tesla Semi's powertrain is also guaranteed to endure 1 million miles. Even if two of its motors fail, the Tesla Semi can continue to operate and outperform a diesel truck in terms of acceleration and range. What else? Musk stated that the Semi would never need brake pad replacements. The natural slowing of the vehicle is caused by brake energy regeneration, which recovers kinetic energy and stores it in an electrical form in the battery. According to Electrek, Tesla may sell the Semi with an automatic tire inflation system, ATIS. The USPTO has granted the company a patent for this technology, which might automatically modify tire pressure and maintain it at the optimal level. The patent application, according to Electrek, named John Furtado as the creator of the technology. Furtado worked on the brake controls, pneumatics, tires, wheel ends, and wheels of the Semi. It will be a cool feature that will save time and promise efficiency if fitted in the trucks. Let's now talk about the electrical system in the Semi. Tesla believes upgrading from a 400-volt design to an 800-volt architecture would be expensive for medium and smaller vehicles such as the Model 3, Model Y, and Tesla Robotaxi. However, Baglino said during the company's Q1 2022 earnings conference call on April 20, 2022, that the greater system voltage makes sense for bigger applications like the Cybertruck and Semi. On larger EVs, where higher charging power, higher power from the battery to power the power electronics, or more torque is required, Baglino noted that going for 800 volts instead of the standard 400 volts allows for enough semiconductor savings. Aside from continuous high performance and shortened charging time, an 800-volt system would minimize cabling weight and installation area. In the case of the Semi, Tesla has gone for 1,000 volts rather than 800. The Class 8 truck is the company's first four-digit operating voltage model. Before we can get to the segment that this video is all about, give the video a thumbs up. Let's now see what the company claims the truck performs and if that's feasible in the real world. Tesla's tri-motor powertrain from the Model S Plaid and the Model X Plaid is used in the Semi. This powertrain comprises two acceleration drive units, performance motors, positioned on one axle, and a highway drive unit, efficiency motor, mounted on the other. The highway drive unit is always active, while the acceleration drive units only activate when necessary, maintaining optimal efficiency. Regarding efficiency, the tri-motor semi uses less than 2 kilowatt hours every mile. When completely loaded, it weighs 82,000 pounds gross. A fully loaded tri-motor semi with a gross combined weight of 82,000 pounds takes 20 seconds to accelerate from 0 to 60 mile per hour. It can reach highway speeds up to a 5% incline. During the semi delivery ceremony, Tesla displayed a video showing a fully loaded tri-motor semi, 82,000 pounds, comfortably passing a normal semi over the Donner Pass at a 6% grade. A semi-quad motor weighing 80,000 pounds likewise takes 20 seconds to accelerate from 0 to 60 miles per hour. The semi-quad motor could accelerate like a mid-range sports car without the cargo, with a 0 to 60 mile per hour speed of roughly 5 seconds. However, there is little question will the semi make truckers' jobs much simpler and less stressful. New drivers may learn faster and with less effort than in a traditional diesel-powered semi. On October 30, 2022, Twitter user Heinrich Zane tweeted a video of a semi rapidly speeding after gently pausing and turning at a Silver Springs roundabout, Nevada. Tesla has not disclosed power or torque data, however, we know that electric cars create a lot of torque, so anticipate the semi's powertrains to produce values in the four digits. What about the range? Well, we know about that. Let's talk about the range in the next segment. The range would be a significant problem for truckers, but fortunately, Tesla has thoroughly solved range anxiety. There are two variants of the semi, one with a range of 300 miles and one with a range of 500 miles, which will be released first. Given the trucking regulations in the United States, the reported amount seems to be more than enough. According to the United States Department of Transportation, truck drivers in the United States are legally obligated to take a 30-minute break after 8 hours of driving. According to Tesla, 400 miles is the average distance trucks traverse in 8 hours. But despite the impressive figures, the key issue is whether Tesla will be able to accomplish these in real life, which even one of the world's well-known trucking companies, Daimler, has challenged. Tesla is allegedly lying, according to Daimler. Elon Musk tweeted the other day that Tesla had completed a run with a weight of 37.7 tons and had achieved the promised range. There are no information available concerning the testing environment. Martin Dolm, the head of trucks at Daimler, said that the reported performance numbers for the semi were false when it was originally announced. He did this by claiming that the laws of physics are the same in Germany and California. According to Bloomberg, there are four discrepancies between Tesla's statements and the present state of battery technology. The first is about range. The semi requires 600 kilowatt hours to 1000 kilowatt hours batteries to achieve 500 miles of range, depending on elements like wind resistance and weather. Assuming a middle of the road 800 kilowatt hour unit, the battery would weigh 10,000 pounds and cost more than $100,000. Tesla experts expect to sell the semi for $180,000, which means $80,000 will go into creating the remainder of the vehicle, including the electric motors. The carmaker intends to save money by reusing displays and motors from the Model 3, but the price of the batteries must fall dramatically for Tesla to profit from the truck. The Tesla Megacharger is another limiting element. To match Musk's promises of 400 miles of range provided to the semi with a 30-minute top-off, the megachargers would need to produce 1,200 kilowatts, roughly 10 times what a Tesla supercharger can now produce. And this doesn't even address the third discrepancy between Tesla's boasts and reality – the costs of such a charging feat. The semi, which costs $180,000, will compete with vehicles that cost as low as $100,000. Tesla expects that by lowering the cost of charging the batteries to 7 cents per kilowatt hour, the trucks will pay for themselves over time, resulting in fuel savings of over $30,000 a year for some drivers. If Tesla wants to accomplish this pricing, it will have to aggressively subsidize its megacharger operation, as it currently does for Model S and Model X users via its supercharger network. What do you think? Will Tesla semi-truck hit these numbers? Please let us know in the comments section. The Semi is a revolutionary semi-truck that has the potential to make transportation simpler, more pleasant, and safer than typical semi-trailer vehicles already on the market, particularly those converted from diesel to electric. It should also be much less expensive to operate and maintain. As an added plus, the zero-emission Class 8 semi-truck is very fun to drive, according to Elon Musk. Be sure to check out the videos being displayed on your screen. Until the following video, peace, I am out.